If you've ever wanted to add a snapshot or flashlight effect to one of your videos, over the next few minutes I'll show you how. Let me give you an example of what I mean by a snapshot or flashlight effect.
Wow.
That's it. The video basically stops, there's a flash of light like a flash is going off, and there's a pause in the video so you can see exactly what's going on. Another example of what this looks like is sort of a rapid succession. Effect there as well. So I'm going to show you how to create these in Adobe Elements, Adobe Premiere Elements version 13. So let me just run through exactly what that looked like in a little bit slower detail, and I'll show you how to create this from the ground up. So basically, as soon as the jumper in this particular video gets to a certain point, we stop the video, we flash a light, play a cute little shutter sounding effect, and then we continue the video on. Quite easy to do in Adobe, so let me show you how. So let's go back to ground zero, let me delete everything, and we'll show you how we created this. So under my project assets, I already have a video picked out, so I'm just going to go ahead and pick it and add it to my timeline. And because this video is rather long and not a lot of fun detail in here, I'm going to clip the very beginning parts of it off. So right around here is where I want to start this particular example, and maybe near the end of it, after she jumps, somewhere around here, I'm going to end it. All right, so increase our timeline so you can see things a little bit better. And let's go ahead and get started. All right, so what we're going to do is I'm going to go to my favorite spot in my clip, right about where the jumper is jumping over the little, what do you call that thing, the rod there. Maybe right around here is where I'll stop it and take an image. So how you do that is go up to your tools, go to your freeze frame, and I'm going to add just maybe a 1 second or so and insert that directly in the movie. Now, so what happens is the clip got split. That particular frame was added as an image, and then the video picks back up. So what we're going to do is put a flash of light in here and a cute little sound. So on my project assets, I have a shutter wave file, so I'm going to go ahead and add this. And you know, maybe 1 second is a little bit too long, so I'm going to drag the end of my image in, and the rest will follow along. So let me go ahead and play that, and you can see what that looks like. All right, now we want to add that little flash of light in there. So how we're going to do that is I'm going to go to this particular clip, and I'm going to go to my effects, and I'm going to add something called image control. Drag image control right on top of my image clip, and it allows me to adjust the brightness and everything else. Now, if I just go to this particular clip and I adjust the brightness, say crank it all the way up, it's for the entire clip, and that doesn't really show the idea of a flash going off. So what I'm going to do, set this back to zero. I'm going to turn on this little stopwatch looking tool to show and hide keyframes. I get the secondary window here so I can dance the timeline at just that selected clip. So what I'm going to do is I want to remember the setting of zero brightness at this point in time. So I'm going to turn on this little toggle animation. It adds a small marker for me. I'm going to go to somewhere around here where I think the flash would happen. I'm going to add another one at zero just by hitting the little add or remove keyframe button. And then a couple frames later, I'm going to, let me zoom in here so you can see things a little bit better. And I'm going to crank my brightness, you know, way up some obnoxious level, and then I'll go one frame more and then crank it back down to something back to where it was, zero. So what's going to happen over time is it starts off at zero, the brightness, then it goes up to that really loud flash, and then it simulates the actual flash of, say, a camera or whatever. Now that's happening so fast there that I might need to adjust these out. So I'm just going to drag these out and move them out just ever so slightly. Maybe to give me a little bit more of a flash effect in there. That might be a little bit better. There. Now I can increase the length of that flash by increasing the distance between this flash point here and you know, it's 58, whatever. You can even increase it a little bit larger or higher. And I can move these points around to give me a little bit longer of a duration of a flash. So now that I've got the flash, I've got the sound. So let's go ahead and play this thing and you can see what the entire effect looks like. All right, that's the first way of doing this. Now, another way of doing it is sort of like rapid succession mode, sort of like when I put my camera on machine gun mode and get 8 frames a second. Maybe you want to shoot maybe 3 or so of these things to show individual points in time of the jumper jumping over the that bar. So let me go ahead and just delete this clip. I'm going to delete the image. I'm going to delete that cute little sound thing. I'm going to expand my clip back to something a little longer so I can capture maybe something here, and there, somewhere over the other side. So maybe before, during, and after the crossing of the bar. So let's, you know the process. Let's go to our clip, tools, freeze frame, and give it maybe a second. Insert the movie. And then we're going to go maybe around when she's at the very top. Tools, insert another freezed frame for maybe 1 second. And these are probably going to be too long, but I'll adjust them later. And then after the girl is over the bar, maybe right around here or so, let's add a third one. And freeze frame, 1 second, and we're done. Now, the sound effect that I'm going to be using is a 3-release shutter that I found on the web. So basically, it's there's one shutter release, another one, and a third one. So what I'd like to do is align my videos with these shutters so they're a little bit more consistent with the sound that's happening. So let's go ahead and drag this in to around here, I guess. So when this one starts, the next shutter fires off. Now I'd like to get this clip the exact same, so I'm going to drag it above onto video 2, drag the ends to snap it, and then I'll move it right where it needs to be. So just kind of an easy way to guarantee the length of all my video clips are the same. Now to get rid of this dead space in here, right click, say delete and close gap, and it deletes and closes gap. So now that if we run this thing.
Wow.
So the other thing that's missing here is my cute little white flashes that happen. Now I have 3 image effects or image segments that I want to add that little white flash to. So I could do it 3 times if I wanted to, or my personal favorite is I'm going to add something called an adjustment layer, which if you don't know where that is under your project assets, go to this little panel options under new item, find adjustment layer, and drag that adjustment layer to some point above your current selected video. So I'm going to put it on video 2. And of course, I want to drag these ends in, so it's just going to affect those image clips that I have. And then what we're going to do is I'm going to go back to my effects, my image control. I'm going to drag that to the adjustment layer. And then I can adjust the brightness on the adjustment layer, which will flow down and adjust the brightness of each of these clips. I can just do it basically on one segment up here. And with a little bit of copy paste magic, I can repeat that process pretty easily. So let's go to the very beginning of our clip. And brightness, let's just say add this 0 starting off. Turn our keyframe on. Go to somewhere around where the noise happens. Add another keyframe. And a couple seconds later, add a very obnoxiously loud white. A couple frames later, let's take that right back down to 0. So let's play this before I duplicate it to make sure we have it somewhat correct.
Wow.
Of course you can't see anything because I got my project assets expanded.
Wow.
So let me close that down. Let's play it again. Okay, that looks pretty good, but I want that same effect to be added to other areas of my clip. So what I want it to do is I want the next one to be somewhere around here. So position your cursor where you want it. Drag with your cursor and select all of these little keyframe points, Control C, deselect, Control V, and it adds them right to your timeline. Then expand your or move your cursor out to where you want it. clicked in the window again, hit Control V, and it adds those three brightness controls a third time.
Wow.
So there we go. That's how you can create a snapshot or flashlight effect using Adobe Premiere Elements. I hope you learned something. Thanks for watching. And if you like what you saw, please give me a thumbs up.